Please subscribe our channel Education Point and press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 220, and today I am going to discuss the ozonization of natural water, that is under chemical treatment of water. And as you know that ozonization is also one of the method used in many countries to sterilize the impure natural water. So ozonization is a type of chemical treatment where the ozone and the air mixture is pumped inside the column and tower of the ozonization, and there this ozone is mixed with rose impure natural water, and the bacteria, especially the E. coli, is killed. And here this ozone is here just in gaseous form, it is blue in color, light blue in color. But once it is in liquid form, it is dark blue. And once ozone is found in solid state, then it is almost black in color. And this ozonization is very, very effective because it kills E. coli bacteria, and it is used from 1% up to 4%. It depends upon the pollution of the natural water, how up to what extent it is polluted. So here I will be discussing one by one the sterilization of natural water by ozonization method. In some countries, the drinking water is treated with ozonized oxygen. And that ozonized oxygen, when it is treated with ozonized oxygen, that sterilization will take place. And in this way, the disinfection of natural water will be there. The plant consists of tower. This is your ozonization tower, made of enamel iron and divided into several components. It is divided into vertical and horizontal several columns in several components by means of perforated celluloid partitions. The tower is provided with two inlets. Here there are two inlets from where the water and ozone air will enter. So from tower, in this the two will enter, and then it will be pumped inside the tower. So the tower is provided with two inlets at the bottom and one outlet at the top. This is the outlet from where the treated ozonized water will be collected. The ozonized oxygen and water to be treated are allowed to pass through separate inlets provided at the bottom, and sterilized water is collected from the outlet provided at the top. Ozone is produced by passing a high voltage current through dry air using cylindrical electrodes made of aluminium or stainless steel. Actually, the production of ozone is very costly. That's why this is the biggest disadvantage of this process, that many poor countries, they cannot afford the purification of water or sterilization of water by ozonization method. In atmosphere, we get ozone when there is lightning, thunderstorm, and heavy storm. In that electric, thunderstorm, lot of ozone is produced. And ozone is very good killer of bacteria. If some in moderate percentage, if ozone is there in air, it will sterilize our throat and air, and even it will control up to some extent our respiratory problem and even asthma. So that's why ozone is very, very important gas, or in liquid form or in gaseous form for our health purpose also. Ozone is an allotrope. Is allotropic. Ozone is allotropic modification of oxygen under normal conditions. It is bluish gas. So in normal condition, it is in gaseous form, and this is bluish in color. In liquid state, ozone is dark blue, and in solid state, it is almost black in color. Its solubility in water is high as compared to oxygen. In nature, ozone is formed by discharges of atmospheric electricity during storms. Experiments show that if 1 milliliter of water contains 274 to 325 E. coli bacteria, is a type of bacteria, then the 86% are killed by an application of 1 milligram of ozone per liter in the water. And if we are adding 2 milligram of ozone in 1 liter, then the water will be fully sterilized. All the bacteria will be killed and it will be disinfected. And that is the way to disinfect the natural water from bacteria. The dose of ozone required for water disinfection depends on the degree of pollution of natural water, but usually it varies from 1 to 4 milligram per liter. Ozonization also gives good taste of water and kills bad odor. So ozonization also is responsible of improving the taste of water, and at the same time the bad odor, because of the oxidation of some organic microorganisms or some organic materials, is also controlled by ozonization process, and water and kills the bad odor produced by oxidation of organic impurities. So there are three advantages of ozonization over chlorination. The A is, it does not add to chemical pollution in water. It improves the organoleptic properties of water. And B, ozonization does not require additional processes to remove bacterial agents from purified water, as in the case of chlorination, that is dechlorination. Hence, higher doses can be used. C, ozone can be prepared in C2. Only electricity is required, and a single chemical reagent like silica gel on which moisture is absorbed. Now the general advantages. A, ozone sterilizes, bleaches, decolorizes, and also deodorizes natural water. Deodorizes means the bad odor will be removed. B, an excess of ozone in natural water causes no danger, because being unstable, it decomposes again into oxygen molecule. C, it causes no irritation of mucous membrane, as in the case of chlorine treatment. When there is excess of chlorine in the chlorine treatment. If you put on skin or other places, mucus, you will notice irritation. The taste of water is improved with ozone. Highly palatable water is sterilized in ozone. One of the most disadvantage of ozone sterilization is that it is not cost effective. It is very costly, because to produce the ozone itself, it has lot of high cost. That's why it is very costly. But the other, like chlorination, it is cost effective, is very, very cheap. So with this, I will stop. Thank you very much.